Hello, I'm Anil Asher with Datawrx, and today we're going to be showing you how to program a Coinco to work as a secondary bill acceptor. You would need to do this if you have two bill acceptors on your machine and an MDBPro controller. Now, on a normal MDB system, you can only have one primary bill acceptor and one secondary bill acceptor. So this is why it's important to program the Coinco to function as a secondary. Coinco is the only bill acceptor that can be programmed to function as a secondary at this time. So you are restricted to using either one MEI and one Coinco bill acceptor or two Coinco bill acceptors, since a Coinco can be configured as a primary or a secondary. So we're going to be using our test panel, and it has a standard configuration of two Coinco bill acceptors, an MEI coin acceptor and coin changer, and then the MDBPro controller. If you have just one bill acceptor, you do not need to do this. But if you do have two bill acceptors, one needs to be a primary, the other has to be a secondary. So in this situation, I've just installed two brand new Coinco bill acceptors. Let's just assume they are brand new. And I need to program one of them as a secondary. By default, they are primary, so we don't need to do a deconfigure at this point. But we will talk about deconfiguring also. To program a Coinco as a secondary, we have to connect just that device to the MDBPro. To be able to do that, I want to first disconnect power to the MDBPro, and that's the power plug on the side. I just disconnected that. Power is off. Anytime we're changing any devices, we want to disconnect power. And then I'm going to disconnect. This is the gray harness that runs to the MDBPro. I'm going to disconnect all devices. It doesn't matter. Physical location of the device does not matter. You can put them in any order in the cable. But here I can see this one is connected. So let's go ahead and disconnect this. So this is one bill acceptor. I want to leave this bill acceptor as primary. I want to program this bill acceptor, which is connected to this cable, as secondary. So I'm going to connect that to the MDBPro. This cable runs directly to the MDBPro. And I'm going to go ahead and disconnect the coin changer. So this end is open. This end is connected to the MDBPro, and that's it. So now when I power up the MDBPro again, by plugging it in, only one bill acceptor comes on. The other bill acceptor has no power. The coin changer has no power. We're going to come to the MDBPro. We're going to press the yellow button. Just click it once. And it goes into the menu, and the first item in the menu is Vend Prices. We're going to go right to System Settings. We're going to press the Enter button to enter System Settings. And we're going to go through the options in the menu. The first option is Quarter Changer. Second option is Single Vend. Third option is Force Vend. Fourth option is Coinco Config. That is what we want. Coinco Config will configure a Coinco Vantage bill acceptor as a secondary. And so I'm going to enter Coinco Config. The default option is no. I'm going to move it over to yes by pressing the right arrow. I'm going to press the enter button. And that's it. It's now configured as a secondary. If I scroll to the right, there is also a Coinco deconfig option, which allows me to convert a secondary bill acceptor back to primary. We don't want to do that today. Now that I've done that, I'm going to go ahead and disconnect power. and I'm going to reconnect all my devices. The cables are connected in a series, in a daisy chain. So again, sequence, the order of the wires does not matter. It is the internal programming of the device which determines how it is going to function. So I connected MDBPro to the first bill acceptor. First bill acceptor goes to second bill acceptor. Again, you can go the other way around, it's not important. And then finally we end at the coin changer. So everything is now connected. Power everything back up. Now we have two bill acceptors on. We have a coin changer that's active. And to test, we're going to insert a bill in each of these bill acceptors. Now that we've completed programming, we're going to test by inserting a bill into each bill acceptor. I'm going to insert one bill into the first bill acceptor. And it shows us a credit of $1. We're going to insert another bill into the other bill acceptor. And we have a credit of $2. Typically, if you do not have them programmed correctly, this is not what you would see. You would see one bill acceptor maybe accepting the money and not showing a credit, or not accepting the money at all. If you're seeing any of these issues where one bill acceptor is disabled or one bill acceptor is taking money and not showing a credit, that usually means that you need to configure it as a secondary. And you have two primaries in the loop. And you have two bill acceptors which are primaries or two bill acceptors which are secondaries, you're going to experience such problems. Go ahead and do the config and you should have resolved the problem. Thank you. I hope you learned something from this video, and we hope to keep producing more. So give us your feedback, give us your comments, and we'll be more than happy to add more stuff. Thank you.